how to practice. Well, one of my favorite psychoanalysts and psychiatrists is Thomas Sass. Probably some of you know him. He's associated with the anti-psychiatric movement. I don't like him because of that. I don't like the anti in most of the things. I try to avoid it. But he wrote an essay, I don't remember now, but I can present it for you. And at some point, he's speaking about diagnosis. And he says that we have to remove ourselves from this. And he said really nice things about Freud and Lacan. He says, even Freud and Lacan, which I consider as the greatest psychoanalyst in their brilliance and genius, they fail to remove psychoanalysis from the diagnosis. Okay, either the structural diagnosis, basically he meant from pathology, but he says about the diagnosis. Even Lacan, he says with this, he couldn't do it. Okay, when you've got, so this is from the practice, again, you've got the analyst, you've got the analysan, okay? Okay, listen to this. We spoke earlier about the oracle, okay? Now, if we remove the word analyst and we put priest or a person, then we put here the Bible, we can put the Quran, we can put everything. You can put the DSM. You can even put the knowledge of the structures. From the moment that you start thinking about the structure of the analysis, I will say some more about it, immediately you are a subject of knowledge. Because you are using some knowledge to understand this phenomenon here. Okay? Of course, there are reasons, which I will reply to these reasons that I received from different analysts in the process. In the best case scenario of the triangular relationship in the session is it's Lacan's teaching of the structures. So we need to foreclose the psychoanalyst. How the psychoanalyst foreclose? When he doesn't have to refer to this, whatever that is. Okay? What is the difficulty? There are some people who
If it's double-sided, that's the page two. Looks like it, yeah.
Okay. So the first step towards what I call the non-body, the formation of the non-body, is the direction of the act. How you are forming a non-body? By trying to foreclose the word psychoanalyst. By what we said yesterday, to have this plasticity to adapt. This is the plasticity that certain psychotic subjects have, but they do it by taking a position against the drive. We don't have to take that position against the drive, but jouissance needs a body. We can say a lot about jouissance desire. I will say later a few more things. But one of the things to separate them is jouissance needs a body. Desire is provided. You provide a body to desire. You have to provide your body. Okay, your being, basically, not the body. Here you will utilize, you will use the other to carry one of your signifiers so you can have this support in the Borromean. Here, this is your body. The Borromean is your body. Okay, so if I'm attracted to specific type of women that they have to carry the signifier hungry or deadly. That is this example from this French analyst. This guy was dating only women that they carry the signifier deadly. Okay? By putting the signifier, even if he was falling in love on the woman that he loved, he turned her into a part of his body. That's a body. That's a body, but it includes maybe another person here. But if they carry our signifiers, then they are part of us. We cannot actually love them. And I want you to compare that with the, I don't know, but let's call it the proper experience of analysis. We don't need the other to carry our signifiers to obtain a body, and that's desire. Okay? We are going to provide a body to something that causes us desire. Okay, let's go to more details. The first argument against not doing diagnosis, structural diagnosis, is because the analysis that they teach, the school of analysis, they teach Lacanian schools. No, you have to do a diagnosis. And then if it's, I ask, okay, but we've got a lot of examples that it was wrong. They said, if it's wrong, you do another one later. They were very serious about doing diagnosis because they wanted to know which position the analyst would take in the sessions. Without that diagnosis, they didn't know how to deal in the sessions. Okay? But I will tell you what Lacan did. Many few people pay attention to that. I did a lot of research on that by talking or reading. I couldn't see it, so I would say it. It's my job. I think it was one of the very famous analysts. He went to Lacan when he was very young. I think the book exists in French and in Greek. It's about people who had experience with Lacan. And there's a chapter about this. I consider him very ethical and good analyst. He went very young there. And during the first meetings, he said two things to Lacan after the first meeting, I think, or two. He got so excited by the intervention. He says, I want to be an analyst like you. And Lacan says, he didn't say you cannot be. He didn't say, oh, you shouldn't be like me because you have to find. He says, yes, you can do it. But for that, you need lots and lots of work. So he gave an orientation towards, you love something, work for it. And the second thing he did, after the, I think it was the first session, I don't think he even cared about the structure, but he told that guy, he heard his signifiers, he heard his topology, the way he was functioning in the world, and he saw that in that topology, something was failing. Okay? So he told him, psychoanalysis is like a book, I'll do the circle again, but you are going to be the protagonist. You are going to write it, you are going to be the protagonist. He used his signifiers, but they were set into this context. Okay? And he took a signifier, he created a metaphor. And what is this metaphor? It wasn't only for the subject orientation, it was, he created a metaphor for psychoanalysis. So if we don't do the diagnosis, the first thing you have to do in the first sessions is to understand what you listen and to try to create a metaphor for what is psychoanalysis. The metaphor will explain and situate the work the work that will take place with these two bodies there within that space. If you fail to create a metaphor, what is psychoanalysis? You don't have to say this is psychoanalysis, but with that he explained the place of the work. He metaphorized psychoanalysis. And you have to do that with every single analysis. You have to find a metaphor related to a symptom. The third thing that happened with Lacan by saying this thing is that, let's say this is a autoembolomia, but here was a trauma. He immediately pointed an orientation towards a solution with that. He pointed an orientation to what has to be done. He didn't put a name. I think he did that consciously, but of course we have to read Lacan as he has read Freud. So I named that. It's from the ancient Greek tragedies. They use it in literature, but it's foreshadowing. He foreshadowed where they have to work. It's like the ancient tragedies, they used to say that, well, this will happen later. Or if you read Saramago, the Portuguese writer, he writes and then he says, oh, this will happen later when they will die or whatever he tells you, but let's wait until we go there. So he said to him, oh, we're going to do that. Metaphorize of psychoanalysis. Immediately this precise metaphor has nothing to do if it was psychotic, hysteric, obsessive, doesn't matter. This is the space where we are going to work, and this is what you are going to do. So it was a direction towards a solution. This is the first thing you have to do if you want to practice with topology. To be able to do that, you must be able to go outside of your own body. Okay? Not to be afraid to to use the knowledge of the structure. Okay, that's the first argument. How we start? Where do we situate ourselves? Well, Lacan told us. He He gave this metaphor. It's a metaphor of a solution. Yes, of course, we are going to speak about the traumatic, about what cannot be said, but we are going to do it in this context and in this direction. Okay? So, metaphorize the experience of psychoanalysis, what they came there to do, according to what you hear, according to signifiers that they have access. Okay, before you do that, you need to have understanding of the figures of speech. You need that to understand how to create the metaphor, but also for later. There are analysands. Actually, there are a couple of ways that we can intervene in the sessions, but not all subjects accept that. I remember a subject that she accepted the first cut after 4 years of analysis. The way she was speaking, it was analysis, but the only way I could approach her body, the body is the Borromean, okay? The Borromean is your body, it's you. If you do it in totally practical ways, it's this. I mean, this with the idea of, okay? So it was only through interpretations, small interpretations. So I have access to this, what medieval metaphor was created there, only through interpretation. In other cases, only through cut. Okay? Yesterday I was mentioned by Penny and Francine about talking. Sometimes you need to talk. And some people say, oh, you left from the analytic position. No, it's not an analytic position. It's not leaving from the analytic position. It's actually an analytic position adapted according to each subject. Because a lot of people say, but with psychotics, is what is happening there is something else at all. If you are going to practice with topology and you adapt according to these things, then it doesn't matter what structure is it. What matters is if they are willing to work or not. And another comment yesterday, I think it was, I don't know who it was, maybe Angel or Penny, anyway, some of you, it was about the work with psychotics. Well, recently we were talking with Penny and Angelos about, yes, you can do work with psychotics if they can have access to desire, provided they are willing to work, and if they manage to build a structure. And actually the changes we see with severely or whatever psychotic subject, or with everybody, it's when they manage to build some sort of a structure so they can place on it their being, their body, their desire, their act. So this is the first thing. If we are working with psychotics, we are aiming, of course, according to the subject, but to give some plasticity to this microcosmos they work by being the object. And then they will manage, they get very creative sometimes, to create some minimum structure. That minimum structure, it's enough for them to experience desire. It's not up to us to say they are not capable. And if they want to go to that direction. So, foreshadowing, okay? It's my own term, not my own term, I borrow some term from somewhere to understand what Lacan was doing there. Because he didn't mention it anywhere, but that was an actual session. It was brilliant because he gave an orientation towards the solution. We're going to work, but this is the orientation. So, the orientation of the treatment, it doesn't have to understand totally the relationship with the other, to try to separate from a specific thing, and orient whatever you have to orient. This is the orientation for me. This is the proper orientation of the treatment. Because think of that. You understand that this subject has to be separated from this signifier, whatever. Practically, you cannot do it unless you assume a position of the master.
This is how you do it.
This is how you do it. Yes.
You mobilize the energy in a new direction.
Yes. Yeah. And the subject, if the first sign, if they are willing to work, they will accept the metaphor. They will accept the metaphor and will calm their bodies. And they're going to work here, and they will give you indication step by step. Okay?